Look towards second, the payoff pitch. Fouled off to the third base side. So the count remains full with one down. Hawks trying to add to a 3-2 lead with a runner in scoring position. Payoff pitch is up and away, and he walked him. So a strikeout, a hit batter, and a walk. Cruz has now faced five batters since coming in to finish off the fourth inning, and nobody's put the ball in play. Cruz struck out the first three, and then free passes inning. Jose Cruz looked towards second. Patino takes off for third. They'll throw for the back runner at second base, and he's just in safely. Chen collects his fourth steal. Patino swipes third, his 17. Count, a ball and two strikes. With nobody out, runners at second and third here in the top of the 10th inning. This game has been tied at three ever since the bottom of the sixth. 2-1 pitch, and Chen hits it right off of his foot and goes down in a heap. He's hobbling around. Get him in the... He got himself in the back foot. He's got the shin guard on his front right leg. And that actually went straight down and got him on the left foot. So everybody kind of waiting around, and his Chen shaking out that left foot and stretching it. No sign of the Hillsboro trainer, though. He's pretty intent on staying in this game. So the Emeralds with the infield in, two runners in scoring position, and nobody out here in the inning. Emeralds are the last game going in the Northwest League. As the 2-2 runs inside. 3-2 the count. And I don't know for sure, but a pretty good shot with the last game going in professional baseball. The payoff pitch, roller to the shortstop Arteaga. They had the contact play on. So Roberson caught in a rundown now between home and third. And the Emeralds have made now three throws to try to get the out. Myrick, the pitcher, finally applies the tag, but it took so long that the trail runners were able to advance. So the Emeralds do avoid giving up the run here, but there's now runners at second and third, just like there were a moment ago, but at least with one out now. There was a moment it looked like if Toribio could have quickly gotten Roberson out, as Patino was creeping towards third, they maybe might have tricked their way into a double play. Instead, they just do cut down the lead runner. They keep the infield in. And here is Ivan Melendez, the big slugger for the Hops.